This is a monument to a famous battle that took place during the War of 1812, which was also the score. We got 18, they got 12. Every year, dozens of tourists come to visit this monument, and today I'm one of them. And like everybody who travels, you want to go home with a picture of yourself standing in front of the darn thing. The problem with that is you got to stop some stranger in some place you've never been before and ask him to take your photograph. And before he can even take the picture, you got to train him how to operate a piece of equipment you barely understand yourself. Then you stand there like a wiener while this goof takes a picture of your feet with his thumb over the lens. So instead, I got Bernice to take a picture of me waving like a tourist, and then I just cut this thing out. Isn't that beautiful? Now you just carry this wherever you travel. When you see something you want your picture taken in front of, like, say, the Taj Mahal or Fredericks of Hollywood, you just stand yourself up in front of it. Then all you do is just frame it just right. Invitation here to submit a contestant for a TV show they're shooting up in the Possum Lake area. It's one of those game shows, Who Wants to Be a Smart Guy? It's one of those trivia deals where they take something that you don't care about and they try to attract your interest by adding cash prizes. Kind of like the way they used to use dowries for ugly women.
Brad, we gotta pick somebody to send to this TV game show thingy.
Yeah, all right. Well, whose head has the most useless information in it?
Boy, that's a toss-up.
Yeah, I know. That's why I made up this practice sheet. It's kind of a test.
Oh, man.
Okay? How deep is the deepest part of the ocean? Mike?
12,000 miles.
You're high.
No, I'm just nervous.
Red, you want to try another one?
No, I don't want to try another one.
Wrong answer. Oh. What has four legs?
No. I'm going to ask you one. What's 5'8" and hates trivia games?
An idiot.
Absolutely right!
It's time to play the Possum Lodge word game! Today's prize is a pocket watch for people who find that wearing a watch on your wrist is just too darn convenient. Red, you've got 30 seconds to get local funeral director Brian Jacobs to say this word. Immortal. Immortal.
Yeah, all right.
Okay, and go!
All right, Brian, you know a lot about funerals and so on. What do you call it when a person never dies?
Bad for business.
Okay, no. What do Peter Pan and Dracula have in common?
Well, they suck.
Okay. If a guy lives forever, he would be...
very wrinkly.
Okay. You know, when people get older, they start thinking about this a lot.
Viagra?
Almost out of time, Red.
Okay, Brian. What do you call someone who just keeps coming back year after year forever?
Oh, Alan Thicke. He's everywhere on reruns of Growing Pains. They've immortalized
there
him.
There you go.
You know, throughout human history, some of the world's greatest discoveries were made in the smallest room of the house. Archimedes discovered water displacement while sitting in the tub. Now, that's where Newton found out about gravity. And it's also where Da Vinci got the idea for the look on Mona Lisa's face. It all happened here, in the restroom. It's a sea of calm in a tempestuous world. That's why Rothschild Sewage and Septic Sucking Services is pleased to announce the launch of our very own Bathroom Classics of Literature. Order now and you'll receive William Somerset Maugham's The Moon and Sixpence, Margaret Mitchell's Gone with the Wind, Marcel Proust's Remembrance of Things Past. Our Shakespeare collection includes Taming of the Shrew, The Tempest, and Much Ado About Nothing. It's my gifts to you. I hope you enjoy.
Voids were prohibitive where void. Handling charges, PST, GST, state tax, and shipping not included. Allow 6 to 8 weeks for delivery. Consult your physician if you are currently on any boredom medication. Can cause headaches and nausea. May lead to abhorrence of reading.
That's the Bathroom Classics of Literature series. Rothschild Sewage and Septic Sucking Services. Available while supplies last.
Rough on a guy to be looking through a car magazine at all the fancy new sports cars and concept cars and then have to go back to his old van. But I have a solution for that. It's all about how your vehicle looks, not how it performs. All that extra horsepower and fancy suspension of a high-priced sports car are just wasted in today's traffic, aren't they, eh? So instead of spending money you don't have on features you won't use, why not just repaint your van and make it look sportier? And I'm not just talking about a fresh paint job. Oh, no, I'm way past that. You ever seen those rooms where they paint the fake windows on the walls? It's called Trompe L'Oeil. Yeah, it's French. It means trick the eye. Well, we're going to do a Trompe L'Oeil 10W30. What you want to do is pick out a concept car out of your magazine. Then you want to draw the shape of that on your van. I would say get something from France or Sweden or somewhere far away so they can't sue you. Now, it doesn't matter if you don't get both sides exactly the same on it. Nobody's going to ever see both sides of your vehicle at the same time, unless you have a really bad accident. Okay, now, everything inside these lines, that's your fancy new sports car. Everything outside the line, you want that to kind of fade into the background, eh? So we got to paint that to look like trees or sky or whatever. And we're going to make it kind of blurry, so that it looks like we're going 100 miles an hour. Once I got my blurry background done, now I got to fill in the shape of the sports car itself. And with that, you could do that with paint, I guess, or plaster, or tar. I decided to go with the handyman's secret weapon, duct tape. It's easy to apply and helps hold the van together. And if you take an old potato chip bag and turn them inside out, looks just like chrome and will never rust. And that's how you turn your ugly old van into a beautiful, sleek European sports car. When you're married, like a lot of us are, you notice that wives make lists. Grocery lists, Christmas card lists, people who owe us a party, people we owe a party to, people who will never be invited to darken our doorway again, or as she also refers to them, your friends. But the scary list is the one she has for you. You know what I'm talking about. That list of odd jobs, big and small, for you to do around the house. Now it's called a list, but it doesn't actually exist on paper. She's way too smart for that. She keeps that list in her head. That way she can add to it without you noticing. And you, sir, will never be finished. You know what? That's a good thing. Speaking on behalf of all men, we're not at our best when we have nothing to do. Your wife knows that. That's why she makes this list. So let's be honest. We're better off married and busy than single and listless. Remember, I'm pulling for you. We're all in this together. Well, Dalton's been going all over town trying to find somebody smart enough to represent us for that TV game show thing. So far, no luck. See, around here, none of us know anything. That's why we get along so well.
Hey, Mr. Green, we found our contestant.
Well, you know, actually, Mike found him.
It was so obvious. Yeah. Who has more information than anybody else in the whole Possum Lake area?
I would say the receptionist at the proctology clinic.
No, Dalton.
Dalton?
I was shocked, Rhett.
You should be shocked, Dalton.
See, Dalton knows all this information because he's been running his store all these years. Plus, he often goes to the library and he reads boring books because he wants to avoid going home.
And they're free!
So you go to the library up and part asbestos?
No, there's a library here in town.
There's a library here in town?
Yeah, right next to the florist shop.
There's a florist shop?
So, anyway, Dalton's gonna go on the TV show representing our area, and if he gets a question he can't answer, yeah, he's allowed to phone a friend.
This must be a friend I haven't met.
No, Red, that's what all these books are for, right? I am going to phone the lodge, right? And you guys will all be here with every volume of the encyclopedia spread out in front of you, and then you just look up anything I need.
We are gonna win a lot of money.
Oh, sure.
I gotta go. You divvy up the books, Mike.
Okay. There you go.
All right.
Oh, look at this. I got volume 16, Time to Win. What do you got?
Volume 7, Going to Lose. This is a talking animals portion of the show with local animal control officer Ed Fritt. So, Ed, what have you been up to?
Well, last week I went up to the behavioral psychology department at Beardsley College.
Oh, yeah, that's where they train all those rats to find their way out of the mazes there.
Yeah, they got a great campus, but after it was over, I couldn't find my way out of the building. Luckily, I saw this rat, and he knew where he was going, so...
Okay, so...
I just followed him.
Oh, that was good. Yeah, I figured that. What do you got for us this week? Well,
today I'm going to demonstrate animal behavior modification.
Oh, boy, we could use that at the lodge, that's for sure. Yeah, what do you got in the thing? Oh, my gosh, that's a chicken you got in there. Chicken.
I'm going to hypnotize this chicken and teach her how to play a song on the piano.
Wow. What song? It's My Poultry and I'll Fry If I Want To?
No.
Oh, right.
Okay. Okay, Hercules. Soon you will be completely in my power. You're getting sleepy. Very, very sleepy.
We're all getting a little bit sleepy about this point, Ed. Ed? Oh, no. Come on, Ed, get you out of here. Here we go. Come on, I got you out of here. Come on upstairs. Ed, snap out of it.
Well, where am I?
You okay, Ed?
Oh, yeah. That was a little weird.
Yeah.
Hi, Winston Rothschild here of Rothschild Sewage and Septic Sucking Services with a lesson for you. There once was a young man from Turkey whose septics were plugged up and murky. They blamed it on lead from the pipes in the bed when the culprit was too much beef jerky.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Oh, and Brian from grade 10. If you're watching, I'm fine, okay? You were obviously wrong about those mushrooms. Anyway, today's educational animated film is very special. It's all about prejudice and believing in yourself with just a touch of violence that the young people today seem to enjoy so much. So watch, enjoy, and learn. Okay, here we go.
Time you two learn to defend yourself against a wild Sasquatch.
A wild Sasquatch?
Fawa is right, Harold, but don't worry. I'm here to help. First of all, due to the large feet on these creatures, they tend to favor a kickboxing style of attack. So, defend yourselves. I want to see your arms in front of your face at all times. Come on now, Red. Arms up. I know you don't want a big Sasquatch foot in the face.
There's no such thing as a Sasquatch. And even if there were Sasquatches, they wouldn't kickbox.
Oh, was that, Gordon? Huh? Did I seem wild enough? Huh?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you seemed wild, all right. You just came in a little early is all. I wasn't quite finished the lesson.
Oh, sorry about that, Gordon. Oh, look, can I try it again? Huh? 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 I'll get the timing right on this next one, I promise.
Well, all right, you big lug, give it another shot. Just don't come out too early.
Nope, nope, I can do this.
Go on, hide. Don't be discouraged, you two. A little more training and you'll do fine. Okay, arms up in front of your face. Very good, now stay on your toes.
Sorry about that.
Well, don't beat yourself up about it, though. It just goes to show you that you can't teach an old Sasquatch new tricks.
Hey. Oh.
Notice how the worst radio stations give off the strongest signals? Kind of like skunks. And then the station that you like has a real weak signal. Tuning that in is like trying to get the right shower temperature. Now, I suppose we could blame society for liking crappy music, or we could blame your radio station for not broadcasting a stronger signal. But I prefer to blame the car antenna factory installation here. Look how puny that thing is. I think we can do better than that. With everybody on cable and the high-fiber optics, these babies are a dime a dozen. And wait till you hear the reception. Oh, no, wait.
You're strapped into competition water skis. You're sitting on the dock, staring down 75 feet of snarled line at a 200-horsepower water ski boat.
Where your deranged brother-in-law is sitting at the wheel, goosing the throttle.
You shouldn't be within 100 miles of that dock behind that boat with that lunatic driving.
You're out of shape. You're out of excuses.
You're out of your mind.
Yeah, but you're way too proud to chicken out. I'll tell you what, though, if you don't think of something real fast, you, my friend, are fish food.
You know, it's just hard to believe that all this started with one beer.
But you know something? The kids were saying you just gotta go for it, and the mouthy brother-in-law was making wisecracks about body fat percentages.
You just felt you had to go for it and show that you had the moves of a 20-year-old.
And now, you're going to die.
You can't bail without humiliating yourself.
This is where 25 years of marriage is gonna save your bacon.
Yeah, you call the wife over, you give her a kiss, you look her straight in the eye and you say, honey, I love you.
Then you add, I only wish I had enough life insurance to provide for you and the children.
Then you look real brave, like you're really gonna go for it.
If she's any kind of woman, and you know she is, she'll have you out of those water skis before your bathing suit gets wet. From the outside or the inside.
Yeah, and your brother-in-law's not gonna argue with your wife.
Oh, especially if he's married to her sister.
Yeah. Just remember not to look relieved, and your secret is safe.
No need to thank us.
That's what friends are for.
But then I'm always surprised when things go well.
At Dalton went down to the TV station. We're all waiting here with our encyclopedias open just in case he has to call for help.
Yeah. Winston even fired up his computer as an extra source of information, but I think he was just showing off that he had a computer.
Yeah. Big deal. I got plenty of computers. I just haven't cracked the passwords yet.
But the television show didn't call. That can only mean one thing. Dalton must have won $1 million.
Oh, yeah!
Mike, did you call for an ambulance?
No. Why?
Well, one just pulled up and Dalton's getting out of it.
Is he all right?
I would doubt that.
Okay, thanks, guys. No! No, I'm okay. You know, all my friends are here. Yeah. Okay, bye-bye. You boom! boneheaded imbeciles. I'd like to strangle you both with my bare hands if I could find them.
Is anything wrong, Dalton?
Oh, wrong? Because of you two, I lost $1 million, and I was almost carried away to the asylum.
What are you talking about, Dalton? We were all down there, had the encyclopedias wide open. There was so much useless information in that room, it was like a session of Parliament.
Well, you know, they tried to phone, but there was some problem, and eventually time ran out, and it... That's when I had to be restrained.
I think maybe they should have given you a tranquilizer.
I am on tranquilizers!
What was the question?
What African animal is known as the custodian of the jungle?
Oh, that's an easy one. That's a hyena. It's in my book here. Yeah. It's a member of the dog family. It's a carnivore, and it feeds on weak and deceased animals, and it lives in janitorial Africa.
That's it?
Equatorial Africa, yes.
You know, boys, that would have been a lot more useful to me a couple of hours ago.
Yeah. Hey, guys. Yeah, I'm off the internet now, so you can use the phone.
If my wife is watching, I'll be coming straight home after the meeting. And I think, you know, studying and learning all this trivia stuff so you're good at a game, I think that's not our style here at the Lodge. We prefer to get our knowledge by accident. And to the rest of you, thanks for watching. On behalf of myself and the whole gang up here at Possum Lodge, you keep your stick on the ice.
Flungus
moritatis. Sit down. All right, men, bow your heads for the man's prayer.
I'm a man, but I can change if I have to, I guess.
All right, man, I got a little trivia question for you. What African animal is known as the custodian of the jungle? I told you it was an easy one.